But if we are ready to go to the market, if we are ready to deploy our product, then we can move to the transition phase, which has mainly to do with deployment and maintenance of a system. So what are the main activities in the transition phase? As we discussed in our initial lessons, in most real-world cases, there are issues that manifest themselves after deployment, when we release our software and actual users interact with the software. Specifically, users might report failures that they experienced while using the system, so what we call bug reports. Or they might report improvements that they might want to see in the software. So typically, this will be new feature requests. And in addition, there might be issues that don't come necessarily from the users, but that are related to the fact that our system has to operate, has to work in a new execution environment. For example, the new version of an operating system or the new version of a set of libraries. When this happens, we have to address these issues by performing maintenance, specifically corrective maintenance for bug reports, perfective maintenance for feature requests, and adaptive maintenance for environment changes. And the result of this is that we will have a new release of the software. Other activities that are performed in this phase include training, customer service, and providing helpline assistance. Finally, if you remember what we saw when we were looking at the banking IT system example, the cycles within a development are not necessarily completely disjoint, but they might overlap a little bit. So something else that might happen in the transition phase is that a new cycle may start. So there might be some activities that are related to the fact that we're starting to think about a new cycle. So now let's see what kind of outcome these activities will produce. The first one is a complete project with all the artifacts that we mentioned before. Another outcome is that the product will be actually in use. So the product will be in the hands of the users and the users will start using it, will start interacting with it for real, not just in a beta testing setting. Another outcome will be a lesson learned. What worked? What didn't work? What should we do different in the next cycle or in the next development? And this is a very important part of the whole process because it's what provides feedback between cycles and between projects. And as we said before, in case we have a next release planned or a next cycle coming up, we might want to start planning for the next release. So another outcome will be the plan for the next release. So similar to the other phases, also for the transition phase, we have a milestone, which is the fourth milestone in this case. And therefore, we have an evaluation criteria for the transition phase that will define whether we reach the milestone or not. And in this case, one important assessment is whether the user are satisfied. So users are actually using our product now, so we can get feedback from them. We can see whether the product makes them happy or not. And we continue assessing whether our expenditures are fine with respect to our estimates. And in this case, problems with this milestone might lead to further maintenance of the system. So for example, we might need to produce a new release to address some of the issues that the users identified, as we discussed a couple of minutes ago.